Hello children, welcome you all to class 9th English class. Today I'll be beginning a new poem, Ethics, written by Linda Paston. First we'll move on to the warm-up activity. Here is a small story related to the curd seller. In the days of remote past, curd sellers used to carry curds in small pots. On one such occasion, while a curd seller was carrying a pot filled with a basket on her head, an eagle was flying over her head with its prey, a cobra. The angry and frightened cobra, in its attempt to free itself from the clutches of the eagle, was striking at the eagle with its hood. In this process, snake's venom fell into the curds. What do you mean by venom, children? Yes, it is poison. A little boy who ate that curds died. A trial was conducted and the curd seller was summoned to the king's court. The curd seller passed on the buck to the snake and the snake in turn to the eagle. Eagle pleaded its innocence and said that it was natural for an eagle to prey on snakes for food. Here, buck refers to the responsibility. So, in this situation, how do you judge? Whom do you punish? Who is right? Whether the curd seller is right or wrong? Whether the cobra is right or wrong? Or eagle is right or wrong? So, we have to think from all the three positions. So, thinking in this situation and finding the moral value of human conduct is called as the ethics. Now, we will see what is ethics. According to the situation, how do you judge the people and find the real fact? That is known as ethics. Today's class, we'll come across a new poem, Ethics, written by Linda Paston. First, we'll know about the poet. Linda Paston was born in 1932 to a Jewish family in Bronx. She graduated from Radcliffe College and received an MA from Brandeis University. She has many awards and honors to her credit. Pushcart Prize, a Dylan Thomas Award, the D. Castagnola Award, the Wes Hawken Prize, are a few to name. She served as a poet laureate of Maryland. Linda Paston now lives in Potomac, Maryland. Open your textbook, page number 159, children. First, I'll be reciting the entire poem, Ethics. Then I'll begin with the explanation. In ethics class so many years ago, our teacher asked this question every fall. If there were a fire in the museum, which would you save? A Rembrandt painting or an old woman who hadn't many years left anyhow? Restless on hard chairs, caring little for pictures or old age, we would opt one year for life, the next for art, and always half-heartedly. Sometimes the woman borrowed my grandmother's face, leaving her usual kitchen to wander some drafty, half-imagined museum. One year feeling clever, I replied, why not let the woman decide herself? Linda, the teacher would report, eschews the burdens of responsibility. This fall in a real museum I stand, before a real Rembrandt old woman, or nearly so, myself. The colors within this frame are darker than autumn, darker even than winter, the browns of earth. Though earth's most radiant elements burn through the canvas. I know now that women and painting and season are almost one and beyond saving by children. Coming back to the first part of the poem. In ethics class so many years ago, our teacher asked this question every fall. If there were a fire in a museum, which would you save? A Rembrandt painting or an old woman who hadn't many years left anyhow. Restless and hard chairs, caring little for pictures or old age. We would opt one here for life, the next for art, and always half-heartedly. As you all know, children, museum is a place where we are able to find the collection of rare things or articles. In this poem, we have come across the word Rembrandt, who is a famous Dutch painter and noted for his handling of shade and light, especially in his portraits. So these are the two famous pictures of Rembrandt, children. Since from our childhood days, we have morals and spirits. And teacher teaches us the moral values by narrating moral stories. In the same way here, the poetess Linda Paston recollects her childhood days and the teacher asking a question every fall. Here, fall refers to autumn season. Question would be, if there is a fire in a museum, which one would they save? Whether a Rembrandt painting or an old woman? Children who were not knowing the value of painting nor the value of life would once opt for painting and next time for an old woman. As they were confused, they were giving their answer half-heartedly. I will continue the next part of the poem in the next class, children. Assignment for the day. First one. What question did the teacher used to ask every time? Second. The children responded to question - Thank you, children. Have a good day.